Good morning, John. It's Thursday, July 26th.
That I did a video once upon a time. I'm here to debunk a myth. It's a simple statement that is really hard not to believe knowing what we know. The internet brings out the worst in people.
Welcome. This is Brotherhood 2.0. Sometimes we put stuff on our heads.
I mean, you see in the comments.
Yes.
Y'all know that the anonymity of the internet allows the deep evil inside of every human, except for me, of course, to spew forth in a fountain of vomitous hate.
A sample of a comment from each section would be something like this. You have, you're gay but you're funny, cool video, laughing my ass off, you're a frickin' genius, and please let me have your babies.
And yeah, there are two hosts on SciShow Space, one of them is male and one of them is female. I would like you to guess which one has constant comments about their appearance every time they're in a video. Just go ahead and guess.
It feels like half the people are saying that you're gay, and half the people want you to have their babies.
But you and your friends, you aren't hate mongers.
I have to point out the irony here.
The other people, those people at the grocery store who seem so nice in person, but then they go home and the internet allows them to shrug off the cloak of cultural necessities, and then they just turn and engage and become giant turd faces.
But I've been able to temper it. I've been able to see that most people are just being very nice and supportive.
I'm thinking, anonymity doesn't bring out the worst in people. It just brings out the worst people.
If I can just shave off the people who either want to be my girlfriend or want me to get a girlfriend, then I can be happy.
The internet. This person goes on the internet and he says nasty things to people. He's racist and he's sexist.
Hello to our new viewers. Welcome.
He doesn't have a lot of friends because he doesn't like people and people also don't like him.
But what is the price of YouTube fame?
On average, he speaks to about 0.02 human beings in the real world per day.
That for every 100 views your video gets, there will be one comment.
Want to express his beliefs in the real world because they are unacceptable. And people like expressing those beliefs makes him and everyone else uncomfortable. Though he doesn't do it.
Very many comments, you can take them each individually and they seem lovely and occasionally annoying.
But on the internet, he not only gets to express his views to lots of people, those people then engage with him.
They start to take shape. And it's a shape kind of like this.
And you don't run into internet trolls in real life isn't because they're normal people with deep evil inside of them. It's because trolls don't talk to people in real life.
Thing is that when you have a big sample like this, every person sees it very differently. For example, your mom will see this, whereas your wife we'll see this.
Because nobody likes them.
This, by the way, this entire episode is conjecture. I've got no research to back this up, but it would be fairly easy research to do because I think internet trolls would be super excited about filling out surveys that graduate students in psychology gave them because they probably love to talk about themselves.
Yourself will see this.
But if we all think that the internet is less great than it is, it will become less great because we think that. What we're looking at down in the comments is extreme selection bias. People don't want to comment because it seems like a hostile place, so only hostile people comment. So a comment will end up way at the top of the video because lots of people are discussing that comment. That isn't usually because there's a good discussion happening. The whole point of a troll is to try and get discussion because they want to get a rise out of people, they want that rush, and they want some human interaction. Get in their daily lives because mostly people don't like them. To you, as a person who has met 90% of them, are good. They're people, just like you and just like me. John, I'll see you on Tuesday.
Said the word cool. John, I'm glad you're feeling better, and I'll see you tomorrow.